Finding gross earnings is only the first step in preparing a payroll. The employer must then subtract all required deductions from gross earnings. For most employees, these deductions include Social Security tax or FICA, Medicare tax, federal income tax withholding, and state income tax withholding. Other deductions may include state disability insurance, union dues, retirement, vacation pay, credit union savings or loan payments, purchasing of bonds, uniform expenses, group insurance plans, and charitable contributions. Subtracting these deductions from gross earnings result in net pay, the amount the employee receives. States that require the mandatory disability insurance are the following five states: California, Hawaii, New Jersey, New York, and Rhode Island. The Social Security tax came about through the Federal Insurance Contributions Act, or FICA, which was passed into law in the 1930s in the middle of the Great Depression. This plan is now called Social Security and was originally designed to give monthly benefits to retired workers and their survivors. As the number of people receiving benefits has increased along with the individual benefit amounts, people paying into Social Security have had to pay a larger amount of earnings into this fund each year. From 1937 through 1950, an employee paid 1% of income into Social Security up to a maximum of $30 per year. This amount has increased over the years until an employee in 2010 paid 6.2% of income to FICA. This rate, however, does have a maximum limit, and for practical purposes in the textbook and exercises you'll see in Math Excel, we'll use a limit of $110,000 taxable limit for the Social Security tax, but we'll talk about what it actually is today. Not only is the employee responsible for Social Security tax, but the employer will match the contribution as well. For 2016, the maximum taxable earnings amount for Social Security taxes is $118,500. That means any wages beyond that amount will not be subject to Social Security tax. There is no earning limit for earnings subject to Medicare hospital insurance taxes. As we stated in the previous slide, the tax rate for an employee is 6.2%. That dollar amount is subtracted from their gross pay. An employer will contribute an equal amount, and that's part of their cost of having employees. The Medicare tax rate is 1.45% with no limit on earnings, that both the employee will have that amount deducted from their wages and the employer will match that equal amount. Self-employed people pay double the amount paid by those who are employees, since they're paying for both employee and employer all wrapped into one. Let's take a look at an example of how the Social Security taxes worked. If you had a paycheck of $855, your Social Security tax would be found by multiplying your gross wage by the Social Security tax rate. So you would have $53.01 deducted from your gross wage, and the employer would pay an additional $53.01. With regards to the annual contribution, and again, this is for purely illustration purposes, in our example, what would be the total tax paid in 1 year for they're setting the maximum amount of $110,000 earnings? Well, all we need to do is take 6.2% times $110,000. So this would be the maximum amount that an individual would be responsible for paying into the Social Security tax for 1 year. In reality, at least in 2016, that's based on the maximum taxable amount of $118,500, which amounts to $7,347, would be the maximum Social Security tax charged in 1 year. How we handle an individual that's getting close to that threshold, and again, for just our example purposes, we'll use the $110,000. And here we have the salesperson who has earned $108,350. Her next paycheck is almost $38,000. And the question being asked is how much will be withheld for Social Security. The maximum taxable income is $110,000. They're currently here, shown in the green. This new paycheck will put them over, and the only portion that will be subject to the Social Security tax is the amount that takes them to that maximum amount of $110,000. Anything beyond that is not subject to the Social Security tax. So we need to determine how much is left for this individual to earn to hit the $110,000. So we will take their current earnings, subtract it from $110,000, so that of this new paycheck, only $1,650 of it is subject to Social Security tax. The leftover amount is at least Social Security tax exempt. That amount remaining then to pay in for the Social Security tax or FICA is the balance to reach the maximum taxable limit times 6.2%, so that only $102.30 would be deducted from the gross pay of this salesperson. Medicare is tax that is paid on all earnings, and the total amount is multiplied by 1.45% of all earnings. The employer is going to match this contribution. For a individual that's self-employed, there is no employer to match their contribution, so that's why they end up having to pay double the Social Security tax or FICA, as well as the Medicare rate. So doubling 6.2 means a 12.4% FICA. Doubling the 1.45% for an employee, for someone self-employed, would be 2.9% for Medicare. Some states have a state disability insurance program, and a typical deduction is 1% of gross earnings on the first $31,800. There may be some variation from state to state, but if an employee is injured and unable to work, the program pays the employee during the period of disability. So let's take a look at an example. If an individual has a gross earnings of $568, their state disability insurance deduction of 1% would be 1% times the $568, or $5.68 would be deducted from their paycheck for their contribution to the SDI program.